sup, Rotten? I have a Mac, you have a Mac. And as a Mac app connoisseur, who better than me to put you onto 9 apps I deem essential to the Mac workflow? These apps are designed to lay low in the background until you need them and then remember, wow, this sure made blowing $2,000 on this thing totally worth it. And guess what? To celebrate a full year on Rotten Apple, I'ma sweeten the deal by giving one of these fantastic Mac apps to a few lucky people watching. And don't worry, it's not first come, first serve, so you don't have to skip ahead on this video or anything to participate. So sit back, relax, and let me put you on the 9 Mac apps to enhance your Mac experience, cherry picked by yours truly. None of these apps are subscriptions, but most of them are paid. So I aim to leave free alternatives that maybe aren't as good, but can get the job done for the most part. Now, let's get into it. I don't know about you guys, but I'm constantly wondering what day it is, how far am I into the week, and what day falls where into the month. Well, it's a good thing this app exists, called Menu Bar Calendar. And as the name suggests, it's a calendar that stays on your menu bar. With one click, you can get the entire month laid out before you, and when clicking on a day, it automatically opens the calendar app where you can set events if need be. It's simple, effective, and enhancing. Now I'm aware that the Mac and the iPhone support very different OSs that are tailor-made to both respective devices for ease of use and optimization and all those words, but that doesn't mean these devices can't share features. Do you know when you highlight text on an iPhone, you're given options on whether to copy the text, etc.? Well, thanks to PopClip, you can now do that on your Mac. That's right, with PopClip, you can cut, copy, and paste by just highlighting the text or area you want. It saves you a few clicks, which can add up over time, and it's very efficient. This app grants just another feature that I feel like should just be built into macOS. Speaking of which, another feature macOS desperately needs is better window management. That's definitely one thing I feel like Windows still takes the crown on. Fortunately for us, there are a ton of apps out there to help out with that. I'm sure a lot of you have already heard of Magnet, and I still highly recommend it. But there's another app out there that I use that's like Magnet with a little more personality, and the app is called Winds. Winds can do what apps like Magnet and Rectangle do, but with a few more features and fluid animation. In case it wasn't super obvious, I'm a big fan of macOS's design and animations, and this app makes it feel all the more macOS-like with the fluidity it adds to window management. Not only that, but it's the only window management app I've seen to operate on the system level, resting right in your settings app rather than the menu bar. It also gives dock window previews, floating split windows for quick arrangement, and an option to shake your current window to hide all the ones behind it, which is a feature I use more than I thought I would. It's a window manager that does more. So I just never look back. Just like anyone else, I tend to lose track of how many apps and finder windows I have open, and it can feel a bit overwhelming at times. Well, macOS has this feature called Mission Control, where you can see everything you have open. The problem is that you have to manually enter each window to exit them, rather than exiting them from Mission Control. Dumb, I know. Thankfully, there's an app called Mission Control Plus that literally does one thing and one thing only. With it active, you can now close the apps and windows in Mission Control. Yes, I know, fascinating. It does do that one thing well though. Now, if you're a Mac user, chances are you use Spotlight to navigate and find files throughout your computer. If you're a mega nerd, you probably use an alternative like Alfred. But there's a newer app on the scene called Raycast that I think you should take a look at. Spotlight is cool and all, but Raycast is just a more powerful search tool on Mac in just about every way. Not only can it find any file on your Mac with ease, but it has a built-in store full of extensions you can download to make it find anything you want, period. You can search Google through it, search for music on Spotify, search for definitions and synonyms, translate languages, do math and conversions, set timers, shut down and restart, make snippets, save clipboard history, even play Snake. And I'm only scratching the surface on what Raycast can truly do. You can even control and activate features from other apps you have installed right through Raycast, like Slack, Zoom, Google Chrome, Arc, Notion, and even Apple Notes. The list is endless. I can't stress this enough. Download this free app and take a look for yourself. I will never be able to do it justice. Paying the subscription gives you access to custom themes, cloud sync, and AI features as well, by the way. A truly insane app. This app is hands down one of the apps that is needed on every Mac. No exaggeration, and that is SoundSource. SoundSource is essentially your Mac's sound control. Sometimes just controlling your overall Mac volume doesn't cut it. Maybe there's an app in particular that you're using that's just way louder than your other ones. Thanks to SoundSource, you can adjust the volume of every app that outputs audio on your Mac and control their volume individually. You can even manipulate your general output and input volumes, as well as the sound effects your very Mac makes. When it comes to Mac audio, no developer quite does it like Rogue Amoeba. Fun fact, they're the ones responsible for being able to share audio on your Mac while screen sharing on Discord. It's their software that makes it possible. They also make a bunch of other cool apps that some of you might find familiar, so shout out to them. Now, to the average Joe, screenshotting and capturing would seem like something you can just do on your computer. But CleanShot X truly makes it an art. You can take multiple screenshots and have them appear in your quick access overlay, and then from there you can make your screenshots pop with its built-in annotation tool, as well as round its corners and make a cool background to make it clean and easy on the eyes. Who knew you could make your screenshots so professional? Not only that, but it can screenshot a specific app window and capture scrolling screenshots for those long texts and websites that don't quite fit your screen. It uses OCR to be able to capture text and have it automatically copied to your clipboard, a self-timer for timed screenshots. You can pin your images and even hide your desktop icons while recording or in general as the cherry on top. Oh, did I mention that it also screen and window records? And you can adjust what you want and don't want to be shown. It can proceed to trim your recording to your liking, because it does that too. Or if you just want all of your options in front of you before you do anything, it has an all-in-one feature. This app has truly thought of it all. Now, one drawback one can argue with is its price, which is a one-time fee of $29 that gives you the full app plus 1 year of free updates, which is a payment method I prefer over subscriptions any day of the week. It's a terrific app that I think is worth the money, but I can understand that some people don't really have it like that, like yours truly. Thankfully, the kind folk over at CleanShot X has given me 3 free app licenses to give to you lucky viewers. One will be preserved exclusively for my paying subscribers over at Patreon, while the other 2 I will give away to random viewers who follow these steps. So listen closely. Like the video, leave a comment on the app that you're most interested in that was featured in this very video, followed by your social media handle. Make sure that you're also following me, not because you think I'm dope, but also so I can DM you if you're chosen. That's it. This video isn't sponsored, by the way. They're just very cool. And if you are thinking about getting it yourself, there's a link in the description that I can kick back on. We're not done with the apps though, so let's keep it going. Let's just say you did record something with CleanShot X, or you grabbed the video from online that you want to show your friends on Discord or something, but you can't because the file is too big. We've all been there, and it stings every time, doesn't it? Well, good thing we have an app called Clop to the rescue. Clop will optimize your file to the smallest possible size it can without losing quality. And it does it for photos, videos, and PDFs. There's a couple ways to activate Clop, but what I do personally is right-click, click services, and click optimize with Clop, and your file is magically way smaller in size with your quality still intact. There's honestly no way you don't believe in magic after using this app. It's actually insane. And last but not least, an app I can see benefiting anyone who moves multiple files around constantly is Dropover. Dropover can move any number of your files from one place to another if you're choosing, by just dragging and dropping them into this thing called a shelf, where it stays there until further use. It's really that simple. You can adjust the sensitivity of it picking up on your drags in the settings, and drag just about anything into a shelf, including images you see online. The shelf also brings many options in on itself. It provides quick action sharing for even more ease of use. This one is a definite no-brainer when it comes to file management time saving. I guarantee it. So, those are my 9 essential Mac apps that can improve any Mac user's productivity and workflow. Do you agree with my choices, or would you like me to do more? Let me know in the comments. Shout out to my Rotten Pro patrons, Vasco and France Kobeck, for supporting me on Patreon. All supporting links will be in the description below. Also, thanks to CleanShot X for making my giveaway possible, and I would like to thank you viewers for making this first year something I'll never forget. Here's to another year of Rotten Apple. Thanks for watching, and if you want to see more of me, you know what to do. My first year of Rotten Apple. We take one small step today, then we take the world tomorrow. Thanks for the support, guys.